What's going on, y'all? Man, long time no see. I know. Well, I got to jump on here real quick, man, and I've got to set some shit straight. So, I see there's some people out here on the YouTube streets that are wanting to put the unedited version of the fucking court case between myself and Dick Nose. They're wanting to put it out there, and, you know, people just can't respect the fact that people don't want to be fucking identified. But that's totally okay. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to get ahead of it, and I'm going to put it out for every fucking one of you motherfuckers to see it. And this changes absolutely nothing about the court case whatsoever. Everything that fucking was said that happened, it happened. Okay? And you guys will see. This is the entire unedited version of the fucking video. Enjoy it.
So it's 23D312, trailer 2, Fred Schwartz versus James Schonk. Sir, what's your name?
James Schonk.
And, sir, are you Fred Schwartz?
Yes.
Okay. And we're here. You all can have a seat at the table. We're here for a hearing on a temporary interpersonal protective order that was entered by Judge Duving. Mr. Schwartz, are you seeking to extend the interpersonal protective order?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you ready to move forward today?
Yes, ma'am.
Mr. Schonk, are you ready to move forward today?
Yes.
Okay. Can I have you both raise your right hands? Are you an attorney, ma'am?
No.
She's representing me today. She's got a presentation.
They said that if we could do this, they're fine.
Are you a lawyer?
Can I speak or no?
No.
Okay. All right.
You can be called as a witness, okay. But you can't if you've witnessed something personally.
Yeah.
But you'll need to step back.
Okay.
She's witnessed all this personally.
Okay. So, Mr. Schwartz, Mr. Schonk, you promised the testimony you give today will be truthful?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to read the petition. It says on November 9th in Boone County, Kentucky, there's alleged stalking, threatened physical harm by stating he may attack me, is thinking of attacking me. He stated he has no fear of repercussion and will not stop the hundreds, if not thousands, of statements and videos about me and my family. James has created a falsified website where he data dumped actual sex offenders from the Boone County, Kentucky, and self-admitted to creating this bogus website where he admits on video he knows I'm not a sex offender but will stop at nothing to wreak havoc on my life personally by slandering my name and reputation by embedding his purchased domain website in every Northern Kentucky website and Facebook page in order to make my entire community believe I'm something I'm not. James has repeatedly threatened me publicly on video via his YouTube channel at www.youtube.com/psychobabble.rap. He has threatened my family and has committed multiple crimes of coercion with his fake website. He has actively launched by making live. I filed a report with Boone County, Kentucky Sheriff's Department last year and attempted to gain a protective order due to him releasing my full legal name, address, vehicles, etc. And I believe October, November of 2022, with pictures of my home and vehicles, he since re-released the same information that now includes a visible written threat of attacking me. I believe they are overly excessive post videos, YouTube shorts, community posts, and live streams on camera constitute this behavior now be criminal in nature by means of stalking, making live documented threats, and has also committed coercion by demanding I or my father and friends do what he states, where there will be hell to pay. This behavior has been being documented and oftentimes recorded to support a year plus of myself being the target of his known obsession with my personal and real life close friend who is a celebrity, Ryan Upchurch. I have had to remove myself entirely from my own platform on YouTube because of Mr. Schonk, the increasingly wild allegations, slander, threats, doxing, and falsification of registries in hopes of this man stopping this behavior. However, it has not stopped and continues oftentimes, many times each day. I do believe with recent threats of violence being stated by him towards me that myself, my family, home, vehicles, and property are at risk by not only himself, but the many thousands of people he's actively speaking to. James Schonk has and will self-admittedly stop at nothing to intimidate me and instill fear in my personal life by means of getting revenge on me because of who I am friends with. He has admitted on video to taking IP addresses in order to gain personal information on anyone coming into his chats. While I understand this is a very unique situation, I kindly ask that my court use their best discretion on assisting me in protecting myself and my properties from this man. Sir, is that all true and accurate to the best of your knowledge?
Yes.
What else would you like the court to know?
Like I had said, we've got an entire presentation here of essentially a year's worth of content that, this individual has created against me, and in retaliation to I guess him not liking who I'm friends with, and him having a problem with what my friend has done on the internet, so he's essentially targeted me for it. He's created multiple websites at this point. One is frank-schwartz.com, and then if you /childhood.html, it'll take you to the original site with tabs and so on and so forth. And I have proof of that as well. Also, he's got one that he's made as fred-schwartz, and it's the same thing. So if you just type in fred-schwartz.com, it's just a regular website. And then basically, after this protective order was granted and put in place, there was a demonstration of indirect contact through that website. Let me see here if I can pull it up just to read you what I've got.
How do you know Mr. Shunk?
He has been targeting me for over a year on the platform YouTube.com.
But how do you know him? Or do you not know him?
I don't know him personally, but he has, like I said, targeted me for over a year for who I'm friends with, which is a worldwide known celebrity. His name is Ryan Upchurch. He doesn't like Ryan Upchurch. He doesn't like anything that Ryan does. And since then, he's targeted me for these acts for over a year. And has since, you know, posted pictures of my house, my address, my full name, is as to the point that one of the posts are still up to this day with an active threat on them, which
so
is why
what,
this...
What is the threat that was made?
I will attack you, or I think I will attack your kid now, is what it is.
Attack meaning physical?
It says attack.
What does it say specifically? Okay. Do you have it?
I do, yeah. Actually, I do.
This is not a criminal case. This is family court. So this is a interpersonal protective order for stalking.
That's fine.
So I don't, you know,
can
I don't know what presentation
up?
You have. If JD, I guess we're going to put it on Elmo. Just show me the threat that was made. And was it made to you?
It was made to my father. And this is it here, if I can step up and show you.
You can step, the computer's going to have to, we're going to have to put it in the record.
This here is, that is a picture of my house with my vehicles. And if I scroll down here under the comment section, and this is currently up still on his website. This is obviously his YouTube channel here.
Mm-hmm.
If you go here, you go to the comment section. The first one that's pinned, it says, "I think I will attack your kid now. I'm thinking about it." And that's a comment pinned by him specifically on a post of a picture of my house with my vehicles. That's my real address. Everything.
Has he ever attacked you personally?
No, just threats.
Has he ever threatened you personally?
Yes, many times.
Do you have those?
Yeah, he has threatened, it's coercion. Basically, if we don't do, or if anybody doesn't make an apology, he's to launch websites with a fake sex offender registry that he's data dumped from the Boone County courts. He calls it the Burlington Sex Offender Registry.
So it's threats of
ruining my reputation, inciting violence on me, my family, my home, my belongings, my property. You know, anybody that's labeled as a sex offender. I'm sorry. Anybody that's labeled as a sex offender, clearly that's inciting violence to, you know, on somebody, and that's all false. I'm not a sex offender. Obviously, but he has threatened to data dump real sex offenders with their pictures and names, and adding me in the mix as far as alphabetical order, and obviously to incite violence on me.
Is he actually requesting that people go to your house and harm you?
I mean, it's... No, not specifically, but at the same time, like I said, anybody that's falsely accused as being a sex offender with their address, a picture of their house, their full name, picture of their property, you know, I believe that's threat enough. And then with posting that saying, I will attack your kid now, you know, I believe that that's more than enough threat.
Anything else you want me to know?
Yeah, this here, it's a video. It says, if Powerstroke don't get an effing apology video geared up, his job will be next. He's threatened at the beginning of all this, upwards to a year ago. He has since appointed me to make an apology video for something I have not done. And if I did not make the apology video, he was going to go after my job and have people send 4,000 heartfelt letters. These are his words. 4,000 heartfelt letters to get me fired from my company. And then this one here, it says, you best be getting busy making an apology video where people are going to write letters to your employer. You best call Ryan too and tell him to fix this, which Ryan is my friend. He's the celebrity. Am I able to play these?
What are they?
They're videos.
Of?
Him.
Making threats?
Yeah. Well, here's coercion. False allegations. Videos leading up to his website launch. He's had videos, basically. Here's one of them here. It says how Fred Schwartz's father put him on a lifelong sex offender list. The day Fred Schwartz's father put him on a legit sex offender registry for life. He's since taken these videos down, and he's been, like I said, he's been playing with these websites. One of them, there are two separate domains. One is frank-schwartz.com, which will essentially take you to the indirect contact that's obviously against this order here. And if you go to fred-schwartz.com, it also does the same thing. But if you backslash childhood.html, it will take you to a website that he has created for me with my picture on it, with a falsified story of my father abusing me, and I believe also saying that I had lured a child into my home to perform sexual acts. And my father was there to essentially sleep with that child's mother to cover it up. These are all false allegations, obviously. But this is a narrative that he has been steering and pushing to essentially, like I said, incite violence on me, damage my character, damage my, you know, my reputation. And obviously anybody that has any type of false claims against them, such as, you know, such as this, you know, this could damage me as far as further employment opportunities. You know, if I were to have children, you know, putting my children in school, and him saying that he's going to implement this in every Northern Kentucky forum there is, including Facebook and all these other platforms. He's data dumping strictly from the Burlington Registry. There's all this. And like I said, I mean, there's still, you know, a picture of my house with my vehicles with that threat that he's made directly on his community tab. It's still there to this day. And that was part of why it was granted, I believe.
And how long has this been going on?
This has been going on since October to November of 2022. And I tried to come up and get an order the first time around when he released my my full name, my address, and pictures of my vehicles, pictures of my house a year ago. I tried to come up and get an order, and they said that it wasn't an immediate threat. And then obviously he had posted this again that's still there to this day with threat to me, immediate threat, saying he was going to attack me with a picture of my house.
Okay.
I don't know how else to take that. I'm sorry.
Mr. Schonk, what would you like the court to know?
Well, actually, I'm shocked that we're here, that this young man is trying to use the courts to continue the game of slander that him and his father and his four friends have unleashed on me and my wife for an entire year and our special needs 10-year-old adopted child. His father, and this man right here, I don't know him from Adam. I'm 63 years old. My wife's 67. We're law-abiding citizens living our life, and I made a reaction video to a fellow named Ryan Upchurch. A girl went missing in California last year on August 2nd. And this young man appeared on a podcast with Ryan Upchurch, who were talking about that case, and they ended up slandering a bunch of innocent people, accusing them of doing something to this girl. And in fact, it was so egregious, there are currently three slander cases in the court against Ryan Upchurch for what happened on that podcast that he was on. I made a reaction video to that. I have a YouTube channel. I do reaction videos to celebrities. I do travel videos, that sort of thing. And I made a reaction video to this Ryan Upchurch, a celebrity. I just thought it was so egregious that a celebrity would accuse a bunch of innocent people from a 3 million subscriber platform. And I said to this young man, I said, listen, I see your YouTube name is Power Stroke. I got a power stroke. We got a lot in common. You guys realize you could get sued for this? And from that day forward, him, his father, and four of his friends unleashed a hell on my wife and I's life that has been so egregious that I am just shocked that we are in this court today, and he's trying to use the court to muzzle me so they can continue to play this game. Now, the scuttlebutt, as of right now, Your Honor, is if they get this restraining order, they're going to take donations from his dad's YouTube channel, donations where people pay money to slander me, and buy a billboard and put my wife and I's picture on it in the town we live in. Now, I don't know this young man from Adam. I wouldn't even know he existed if him, his father, and his four friends hadn't unleashed this campaign of hate against me and my wife. And I have thousands of witnesses to this, and several videos. His father created a YouTube channel for the specific purpose to slander me. This young man, the day after I made that reaction video to his celebrity friend, they think this guy's a god, and nobody's allowed to say anything about him. And I made a negative video about this celebrity, not knowing this kid from Adam. Next thing I know, he's on my Facebook. He goes back 25 years, gets a hold of a woman I was married to 25 years ago, convinces her to come on his podcast, and he allowed her to slander me at will for 3 hours. And then he unleashed a whole series of videos called Roundtable Discussions. And there are five of those. One of them ran as long as 8 hours. And Your Honor, if you stopped that video at any time during that 8-hour period, you'd hear them slandering me. His father hovered over my house in Google Satellite View, gave my full name, full address, telephone number, birth date, and last four of my social. They then paid a guy to drive 4 hours to the Muskingum County Courthouse in Ohio to get transcripts from my bankruptcy hearing 20 years ago, and his father read it line by line and dissected it line by line on a live stream showing all my financial information.
Yes, sir, what has he done? I'm not talking about his father.
He was there with his father doing it on the channel, right there with his father. I've got videos I can show you.
Did you create these websites?
I did. In retaliation, I went to the courts back in when he brought my ex-wife on his podcast, let her sit there and slander me, and then his father launched this channel and two of his friends, all at the same time launch channels to every video on their channel slandering me. Every single video. There's over 200 videos on one channel. Every video slandering me. His father just privated over 100 videos slandering me. And so, as you would know, this is in retaliation. I tried everything. We went to the courts. I was told nothing could be done. I was told unless it got physical.
Mr. Schwartz, were there videos that you made regarding Mr. Schonk?
Yes, there were previously, but not to the caliber that he's speaking of.
I got them right here.
Yeah, I mean, this is...
Okay, I've heard enough.
Under oath?
Stop.
I'm sorry.
You're both under oath. Stop. This is not a family court issue. I have to find that there is an intentional threat of sexual contact, serious injury, or death. I don't find that here. What I find is two people who need to go to the county attorney's office and talk to them about the issue.
This is
a criminal harass. Stop talking. This is an issue that you all need to speak to your county attorney or to the sheriff to do a stalking, harassment, something. But there's things going back and forth here, and it's not something that I can issue an order over. I have very limited circumstances, and it's very limited on stalking. And so I don't find that, and so I'm going to dismiss the petition, but you both need to go talk to your local county attorneys. And Mr. Schwartz, yours is right across the street, and they will talk to you about this.
There's no immediate threat to a picture of my house.
Sir, I've made my ruling.
Picture of your house. Ten-hour
live stream. Leave, or I will put you in jail if you don't stop talking. I have asked you to stop talking multiple times. It's time to leave.
Good. Thank you, Your Honor.
Thank you.